Hey, folks. I've been a little apprehensive about sharing my PhD work with you. In many ways, the stuff I've finished is still in the early stages, but today I want to talk about the theories I'm employing to answer my questions about what history is exactly. I feel I may be onto a definition, and to explain, I'm going to show why the danger of losing something like net neutrality is similar to how water becomes ice. A little unclear? It'll make sense in a minute. This will be a bit of a strange video. A typical step back episode covers stories from the past or ideas from history. The subject today is less events and occurrences, but theory. And to finish off, I'm going to use a theory to show why net neutrality is something we need to fight for. I'm Tristan Johnson, and this is Step Back History. Many of you probably know that I study 9/11 for my research, but what you might not know is that I'm using 9/11 to look at how memory becomes history. Because 9/11 was one of the first major news events of the internet age, I had to become a little bit of a historian of communication. I've spent a lot of time thinking about how the internet works as a whole, in an attempt to study how these technological systems shape the way most people experience and remember important events. I've come across a theory called critical junctures. Communication scholar Robert McChesney wrote a book about the concept. When we study the way organizations function as systems, we find they go between stable periods and dramatic changes. And this occurs in all sorts of systems, from boardrooms to buildings to computer networks. Historians borrowed this concept from science. If you have a water bucket and put it in a freezer, you're removing energy from the system. Once it passes a certain temperature, the water crystallizes into ice. At that point, returning to a liquid state takes more time than it did to freeze. Now, how does this apply to a technological system? Everyone remember the VHS tape? Movies used to come in two formats, VHS and Betamax. Betamax had higher quality and lasted longer than a VHS tape. However, it lost the fight, and Betamax fell into the wastebasket of history. VHS won out because it was a bit cheaper. However, it wasn't that much cheaper. So why did an entire format fall away because one gave you a tad lighter pocketbook? When it comes to technology, it's easier when we're all on the same page. And it's even true if the page isn't the most efficient one. And these forces show up a lot. It's why we all move to Facebook. It's why we use the metric system. Well, most of us. And it's why we all got cell phones so fast. In the same way, any system or organization can appear to be stable until it passes a threshold, which can upend everything in quick order. This can be a scientific theory, a technology, or in my case, a terrorist attack. All of these are examples of critical junctures, and McChesney applied the concept to the internet. And this leads us to a second theory, path dependence. When these critical junctures pass, going back might be difficult to impossible, and the system has changed forever. Let's use radio as an example. At the moment, we have certain radio wave spectra allocated for different tasks. The government licenses stations certain frequencies, and stations pay a lot of money to get these frequencies. This wasn't always the story. Many tiny stations ruled the airways when radio first began, but over time, the need to clear up overlapping frequencies pushed the government to clamp down on who could run a radio station. Starting a radio station quickly became expensive. Big companies took over, and we're left with the radio system we have now. Many historians would argue radio would be a different technology if we had made a different decision, and we'll kind of never know if that's the case. And here's where we come to net neutrality. These two theories, critical junctures and path dependence, give us many reasons to champion an open internet. Internet scholars argue that if the level playing field goes away, we could see a phase change in our times defining technology. The internet, like the radio before it, could become a place where the price to set up shop is so high, only a few people get to play. Once we take that path, it's hard to untake it. If we allow for the tiered model and it shuts down new and innovative companies from competing with the online businesses already established, then we could see a chilling effect on innovation. And while I wouldn't weep tears for the demise of Uber or that weird juice squeezing machine, it would shut down investment in new internet businesses. Before long, the internet would be in a different state, like the water turning to ice or Betamax turning to VHS. Given how money and politics work, we might not be able to get net neutrality back after we lose it. Even if we do, the internet will look different than it does today. And what would be there? Well, it would probably suck. What do you guys think about all this? Does theory belong in history? Has the critical juncture passed for the internet? Let's have a chat down below. If this is your first time here, push the subscribe button because you want more history, right? I also want to announce a second channel I started a few weeks ago. It's called Historian IRL, and it's a place for me to let my hair down and talk a bit about life as a historian. give advice, and do general vloggy things. There'll be some great behind-the-scenes stuff there, too. I talked a little bit about my research here, but on Historian IRL, I'll be documenting the story as it turns into a real dissertation. I hope to see you there. And last but not least, I want to thank these kind patrons for their support for Step Back, as well as Don and Carrie Johnson. You make the magic happen. I'm Tristan Johnson. Be brave. Stay wild. We'll see you on the next adventure.
Oh, hey everybody. So it just so happened that Tristan and I crafted a scenario together on my channel called Alternate History Hub, imagining a world where the internet was never invented. Well, it's more complicated than that, but that's why you should probably go check it out. Anyway, just wanted to pop in so they'd know. Okay, I'm going now.